So we're using the music generator, gesture music generator. Touch on it in a sec. We should be doing, we have too many windows open, so we'll be doing some sort of parameter reduction. So first of all, let's try cursor. Well, first impression, I didn't actually like it. It's not much different than GitHub Copilot, which I actually got rid of. We still have the account active, you know, the premium, whatever, until the end of the month. But yeah, essentially not using it. But yeah, trying to. Well, we had this code, for example. So I tried to load the whole project. Yeah, there was no functions to. Yeah, that thing you can tell. You can tell here, for example, that yeah, it took Visual Studio Code, forked it. I don't think they even did a good job at just doing that. Yeah, well, this thing that comes up that's pretty annoying. This GIF. There's no menu. So, that thing. I mean, come on. Everything else looks the same, so it looks the same as Visual Studio Code, but yeah, just more annoying. The chat. Oh, why did they put the. That is. Yeah, it doesn't matter. All of it is Visual Studio Code anyway. In the menu. What's it called? Cursor. Yeah, this add cursor above and below, it's nothing to do with cursor, of course. No, just not good, not good. The suggestion this was giving, yeah, essentially, yeah, was pulling ChatGPT, but interestingly, it's actually giving you a limit on how many prompts you can use. As opposed to the actual ChatGPT, I don't think it will give you any limit, and you can talk to it as well as text-to-speech embedded, which is what I really like in terms of suggestions. Yeah, it didn't have anything special to say about the code. Yeah, I don't like how it's placing placeholders as well. Don't like it. It brought NumPy back. It like commented it out in the code. So it's like, okay, it's picking up on the commented out bit and suggesting to bring it back. Okay. Video file clip. Anyway, parameter reduction. We'll close the cursor for now. That being said, yes, we still have access to, so for example, if you're doing the same thing with GitHub Copilot, I'm pretty sure it will say the same stuff. Oh, they have this thing where you can talk to the entire code base. Well, in GitHub Copilot, those are the workspace handle. Yeah, if we close, let's close all for a sec. Yeah, so because we need to edit some videos, we haven't published a video today. We have a gazillion of material. Yeah, if anyone is interested in some video editing, do let me know. But you have to be interested in the topic at hand as well. I get a lot of marketing people and SEO specialists, whatever. No, those get blocked. Yeah, we have this Python code that automates a video editing. Yeah, if we use a Copilot on this. Yeah, so first you have those handles. So this is what I think in, I already forgot the name, doesn't matter, whatever, cursor is, has, you can talk to the code base, whatever, yeah, the implementation. Just the first impression of it is not good, but yeah, let me know if I should look at it again, something. But if we highlight the code, ask a question. Yeah, it works fine. The only reason I canceled my subscription is because it seemed to be geared towards programmers, and I'm not a programmer. Therefore, I like the canvas a lot because you can also have a general conversation as well. Yeah, we normally start by, hey, who am I? Followed by, what is it I do not know yet? Apparently, I don't know a lot of things.